Now I'd like to welcome Jacquelyn Serwer, who is the chief curator of the National Museum of African American History and Culture. She'll make a few remarks, and she is filling in for Rex Ellis on the program. He was not able to be here with us tonight.
Let me first say that it's a great pleasure to be here with you this evening and to bring greetings from our director, Lonnie Bunch, our deputy director, Kinshasa Holman-Conwell, and our associate director, Rex Ellis, who, as was said, asked me to represent the museum as he was called away unexpectedly. We are especially honored to join in expressing our appreciation to Johnnetta Cole, not only for her service as director of the National Museum of African Art, but for her years-long support to the National Museum of African American History and Culture as a member of our scholarly advisory committee. We could not have done our job without Dr. Cole and her colleagues on that committee. I look forward to the exciting presentations and commentary this evening, and I want to congratulate the National Museum of the American Indian for organizing this extraordinary program. So looking forward to hearing the other speakers and the commentary from the audience. So thank you.
Colleagues, friends, my sisters and my brothers all, let me say that I was so grateful to Brother Director Kevin Gover for warning me, telling me, advising me that I would receive the blanket I just received. We were actually in a meeting convened by the secretary of the Smithsonian. And when Kevin said that I would receive and be wrapped in that blanket, I lost it there. So you can imagine what I would have done here if I hadn't known that it would happen. I want to thank each of you for choosing to spend this evening here in this magnificent, important, and sacred space, the Smithsonian's National Museum of the American Indian. I must, before I say anything else, offer special appreciation to two dear friends who are here. The former president of Gallaudet University, that university's first deaf president, I. King Jordan. And he is here with his lifelong partner and wife, Linda Jordan. Thank you for being here. And I have to say, I'm glad my hubby, James Staton, is here as well. Now, you obviously chose to come here on this particular evening during Black History and Black Her Story Month. You chose to come here to participate in a program that will involve wrestling with persistent stereotypes about African, Native American, and African American people. We are in incredibly uncertain and troubling times in which stereotypes and bigoted comments about these three peoples and so many other marginalized communities are in the discourse that is fueling such divisiveness in our country, and such divisiveness is also apparent in many parts of our world. It is at such a time as this that we really need this symposium. My remaining comments are focused on the significant way that organizing and presenting this symposium is a sterling statement about the power of collaboration and partnerships. Now, here at the Smithsonian, we talk a lot about the value in having our museums, our research centers, and of course the National Zoo work together. Well, this symposium walks the walk. A humongous thank you to colleagues from the National Museum of African Art, the American Indian, and African American History and Culture for working so incredibly well together to make this symposium a reality. Now, I am actually going to call the names. I'm going to call the names of these colleagues as an expression of my gratitude and yours. From the National Museum of African Art, the two individuals who took such leadership in planning this event, Lanisa Kitchener and Eddie Burke, joined by Katie Anchin, Kim Mayfield, James Parker, and Veronica Shaw. From the National Museum of the American Indian, Elizabeth Geish, Eileen Maxwell, David Penny, and Tanya Thrasher. From the African American History and Culture Museum, Deirdre Cross, Beverly Morgan Welch, Rex Ellis, Rhea Combs, and John Goff. And oh, how good it is to be in a committed professional partnership. We at the National Museum of African Art have an extraordinary partnership with Accenture. And so it is not Marty from the top of my heart that I quickly say this. It is, if I could draw it out, it would be months that I would say this, that we so treasure the way that you and your company support our work, and now, as shown by this particular program, the way you are committed to working across the Smithsonian. We thank you. I also want to just do a very quick praise song for a partner extraordinaire, and that is our acting provost, Richard Curran. I have to tell you, the brother provost, you know, when something like this program is so important, he is there for us. And I don't just mean in terms of the monetary support that he contributes, just as Marty did. But you know what, Richard? You just keep showing up, and we appreciate it. Finally, in terms of partners, I want to acknowledge the brother director of this museum, Kevin Gover. You know, we've been trying to figure out who had the idea first. And then we finally said, como dice en español, no importa. You know, it doesn't matter. The point is, we are here. Let me end my remarks by leaving you with three proverbs or sayings. Now, I know I love proverbs because they are an instrument for teaching. But since I've talked about collaboration, I've talked about partnerships, here are three for you. An African proverb, specifically from Ethiopia: when spider webs unite, they can tie up a lion. From the Seneca people, a Native American people, that begins that he, I think I can add, and she, he or she, who would do great things, should not attempt them alone. And from the lore of African American culture, specifically, no doubt, coming from Southern Black culture, where I come from, here is the saying: even old Satan couldn't get along without plenty of help. And so now, please let me not use a formal introduction to bring Monty Rodgers here to this podium, but to say this simply about Marty. He expresses his personal and his professional commitment to the kind of world that I do assume each and every one of us here dreams of. It is a world where diversity is acknowledged, where diversity is celebrated, because it is the way it should be. Marty?
Okay, so I'm going to be really brief, and I'm just going to say, hey, it is awesome to see a full house here tonight. So it's just really, really terrific to see everyone. I have a particular delight in being here for four really quick reasons. The first is, as a person of color, African-American, Native American, and Latino all wrapped up into one, first people, immigrant and coming in search of the American dream and forcefully imported, this is an important topic. This matters, and it matters in particular in this day and in this time. Second reason I am particularly delighted to be here tonight and see all of you here tonight is this also represents the first coming together of these three very important, very sacred museums, as Dr. Cole described them. But to have innovation and to have collaboration across the National Museum of the American Indian, the National Museum of African American History and Culture, and the National Museum of African American Art, of African Art, is particularly important, and it's the first time that it's been done, so it's historic. So excited about that. The third reason that I'm particularly honored and excited to be here tonight is just that we got to pay a special tribute to Dr. Cole, who has been one of my sheroes in life, using the term that she would use. We actually started working together almost 30 years ago when she was a board member at the Points of Light Foundation, and later when I was working at the Children's Defense Fund. And so she is, as everyone here knows, a remarkable woman of grace. And I know that Kevin and the museum gave her a blanket. We at Accenture gave a check for $25,000 to the new scholarship fund in her honor. So. And I would just say about her, as we are having this topic and wrestling with this topic, part of what this topic is all about and part of what our country is in so great need of is the creation of both space and of grace. And she exemplifies having been able to do both, to share her grace and also to create space where people can come together, share ideas, be their full authentic selves, and collaborate and innovate together. Lastly, folks, I gotta be blunt. I am really happy to be here tonight because it means I am still employed. I was really worried about this for a while, so while these guys were debating, was it Kevin's idea, was it Janetta's idea, and both of them are very humble, so they wanted to say, oh no, it was her idea, no, it was his idea. They kept going back and forth. And the original title, just so you know, it was so long, it had like semicolons and dashes and all this other type of stuff. But I don't think everybody really knows how this all came about. So they came up with the idea, however that came to be. Dr. Cole, because of Accenture's commitment to inclusion and diversity, it's one of our top priorities. We aspire to be the world's most diverse company. That's our aspiration, bar none. And so as part of that journey, Dr. Cole was doing a panel in front of about 400 folks, our African American and Hispanic Americans here in the DC area at a fireside chat with our CEO. And so in the middle of that conversation, she raised this idea. And our CEO, Julie Sweet, who's just amazing, she's also just very a matter of fact and gets things done. And so she said, so Dr. Cole raised this idea of Tarzan to Tonto, and we should do this symposium. And of course, Julie Sweet says, sure, done, let's do it. And they moved on to the next topic. So that was in the spring. Came fall, and all of a sudden I get a ping from Julie Sweet saying, well, where are we with the symposium? Where are we with the exhibit? And we hadn't really started planning. So I called up the museum, and Dr. Cole was traveling the world, and she was doing all of this stuff. And I was like, guys, I don't think you understand. Like, we've got to get going on this symposium. And so Julie kept checking in, and she kept saying, okay, well, we're ready to cut the check. Are they ready to have a symposium? And so long story short, I'm really glad it came together, because otherwise I wouldn't be employed still. So our honor to be hosting you and to be part of this evening, and thank you very much.